instructions at all times. Affect the rate of one way through. Defend yourself at all times. That's it to more. Such goods.
So Raymond Chapman hopes tonight is another step along a road that leads to the undisputed featherweight champion of the world, Amanda Serrano. Before any thought of that, though, she makes the first defence of the WBC international title she won last September against the experienced Linda Lecca from Peru. And she's talented, Raven Chapman, Richie.
Yeah, very talented. I remember when she boxed up at GB, in the GB squad. Talented boxer indeed. She travelled all over the world with the GB team and won many, many medals for the squad. So yes, she's very compact and she's got good skills indeed, and she can punch as well. She's got very good power as Raven Chapman, so this should be a good test for her though. This is against the former world champion, although be it at super flyweight, Lecca. So this will be a test for Raven Chapman.
Chapman is physically bigger, 5 inches taller than Lecca. Who's more experienced, just the 6th fight tonight for Raven Chapman compared to the 24th tonight for Lecca from Peru. Richie makes the point about the power that Raven Chapman brings to the ring tonight. I think if she does get a stoppage here this evening, Richie, it would make a statement, wouldn't it?
Absolutely. You know, she's naturally the bigger boxer here, and so you can see what Lecca's doing. She's hitting, she's moving, she's up against a bigger opponent, so she's using the mobility. And that could be a problem for Raven Chapman, just to pin her down. That's a little bit better from Chapman. So she needs just to cut off the ring space, maybe back her up onto the ropes and then work the body. But you can see what Lecca's doing. She's hitting and she's moving. She's trying to be more mobile.
Boxing moving backwards in the opening round. Linda Lecca. It's been Raven Chapman who's been coming forward. What a nice body shot that connected well. Made a bright start here for the 29-year-old from Wickham, Raven Chapman. Final few seconds of the opening round, scheduled for 10 this one, WBC international featherweight title on the line. The first defence tonight for Raven Chapman, who's had a good round to kick things off here at the Telford International Centre.
Than ever, but nothing can do what a soldier can do.
Welcome back to Telford. The top of the bill tonight is the rematch between Stokes, Nathan Healy, and that man there, Jack Flatley from Bolton. He's arriving tonight at the Telford International Centre. Nathan Healy's already been sacked in a seat about 10 yards away from you and I, Richie, watching some of the undercard fights, and he was the picture of calmness, wasn't he? And his fans are in and they're making a noise already.
Yeah, looking forward to it. It should be a cracking fight.
Second round of this one then. The black and gold of Raven Chapman and the red and silver of the Peruvian Linda Lecca.
Good start again from Chapman, but more sustained pressure here, keeping Lecca on those ropes, and that's where Lecca doesn't want to be. That's when her feet will come square, and that's when she'll be open to more body shots. So she's got to keep the movement going here, Fletch. Whereas Chapman, this is good stuff. Just maintaining that gap as well is Chapman. She's not going over the front foot, she's not falling into her opponent, keeping that distance and gap. That's good boxing.
All of the attacks so far have been mounted by Raven Chapman. Majority of the fight so far has seen Lecca with her back to the ropes. Lots of experience though, former world super flyweight world champion, so there's lots of pedigree as well as experience. John Latham, the referee, just telling Raven Chapman to keep the punches up.
Yeah, shame that was. A slightly low punch, I think it was the left hook to the body, just strayed a little bit low, but the attack was good. And Chapman, and again pinned Lecca on the ropes, so she's got to sustain the pressure, double up the attacks and push Lecca back, and just trying to restrict that movement, and she can do that by keeping her on the ropes. got to keep the attacks going. That was a nice shot there.
Followed up with a stiff left jab as well, Raven Chapman. The big difference is experience. It's the 13th title fight that Linda Lecca has been in tonight, compared to just the 6th professional fight all told for Raven Chapman. So she's very much a fighter in the ascendancy against a woman in there tonight with lots and lots of experience.
Good movement from the head of Lecca, side to side, trying to avoid shots. But the bodywork again from Chapman is better.
Coming home to your tender sweet home in your mind, one and only one. Baby, 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 I'm coming home. I need you, baby. Yeah.
Corner, yeah? Little dream. How you feeling? You feeling good? Yeah, plenty of energy. Good. So keep feigning on the way in, just keep little touching going on the way in, alright? When you get there, look to take those angles out on the either side. It's alright, it's fine, it's round two, don't worry, alright? You're absolutely fine, alright? Just keep doing the right things. Cut, angle change, then let the hands go.
It's a happy corner at the moment, Richie.
Yeah, I think it was good instructions there. And Chapman, they're pleased with what she's doing. Asking her just to cut that ring space off a little bit better. Don't follow the opponent, but just step across rather than following her. And that's what she's doing. I think she's boxing pretty well. That double jab, that's important. If she feels she's a little bit too far out, double up the jab, close that gap down, then follow through with that right hand. But the target must be to back up onto the ropes like she's doing now.
Good work by Chapman again. A dominant start to the fight for Raven Chapman. Not seen too much at this stage in terms of attacks from Linda Lecca. Has found it difficult in the early stages here, Richie, to keep Raven Chapman off her.
I think the tactic from Lecca early on was to hit him, to move and just to have a look at Chapman. Now she's starting to hold her ground a little bit more, but that may suit Chapman because Chapman is starting to connect when she is holding her feet. So for me, I think Lecca's got to keep the movement going. I think that makes it awkward for Chapman. But again, it's better work from Raven Chapman coming forward.
Good atmosphere inside the Telford International Centre. The crowd were in nice and early, lots of them here to see Nathan Healy a little bit later on. Raven Chapman's time to shine at the moment though, defending the WBC International Featherweight title over 10 two-minute rounds, and she's made a really good start to the fight. She's been the dominant fighter in there. One significant thing to keep an eye on is the fact that Lecca's only been stopped once as a professional, and that must be in the back of Raven Chapman's mind tonight, the impact it could have if she can force the stoppage.
I think that would be a tremendous result for her. I think Lecca's probably struggling with the work rate of Chapman at the moment. Chapman just keeps coming forward, another good round.
A little story. It doesn't matter where you read it or share it. That one little story can open their world to a lot of possibilities. But one in five children say they don't own a book. So we provided over 130 million books since 2013. McDonald's. Change a little, change a lot.
Now, really focus. When you get down the opportunity, get down that body, right, really grip those feet. Let her have those body shots heavy. She's starting to get tired, and it's all because of the amount you're hitting her body. So touch her up the gloves, bang, bang, hard. Try and change the line for me. If you can go round her either side after those body shots, you'll get two or three shots to the head, I promise you. All right? Keep going.
Stuart Scott doing the talking in the Raven Chapman corner. Very upbeat, very positive. No surprise in that, Richie, the way the fight started.
I think he's right what he's saying. He's saying your body shots are slowing her down, making her hold her feet, which they are. And that's presenting more opportunities for Chapman. And again, it's a good start. Good left up to the body there from Chapman.
High volume of punches so far from Chapman. That was to squeeze a decent body shot in the middle of that combination, Chapman.
That's when she can land that right hand over the top, Fletch, the way Lecca is just moving to her left, and with that low lead hand there, it wasn't too far away there, you see. So she's got to time that shot. As Lecca moves to her left with that low lead hand, that's when she could walk onto that right hand over the top, but Chapman's got to set that punch up.
It's been a fight so far where Lecca's needed all of the experience to weather this storm that's coming her way. She's been on the front foot from the opening bell, Raven Chapman. A really high volume of punches, high work rate.
Yeah, and she's switching the attack occasionally here as well, Raven Chapman, going from the head to the body.
I feel as well, Richie, with the physical advantages that Chapman has, the longer the fight goes, you would feel that they could be significant as well.
Yeah, I think you're right, Fletch. You can see the strength in Chapman now. She's really starting to put her shots together. Good body work there from her again.
Lecca firing back off the rope, but not making too much of a dent in Chapman, who's really up for this tonight. Really good support inside the arena as well for her. Another good round.
Well, she hasn't lost the round yet, Raven Chapman.
Just give this one a little swivel. Can we have the bucket quickly, please? Just give us a little swivel.
Good work again. A little bit too far out there, but she carries on with the attack. That's a nice little left up to the body. Just misses with the right hand there. Lecca's in that corner. Dangerous place to be. That was a lovely little right up on the inside there from Chapman. Then a right hand over the top, and she kept the attack going.
You can do it, yeah? Don't stop your feints now. If anything now, I'd like to see the slightly bigger show of those, because her movement's gone a little bit. So drop the lead shoulder down, bring that big backhand over the edge, or drop your shoulder down, backhand body left again, right? Start working up and down. As soon as you finish now, it's up the edge, change the line. You got that? All right, you feeling good? Yeah?
Sure.
Got back to energy? You're battering up. Keep going, all right? More to say. Don't finish on body now, all right? Don't finish on body. Body, body, head. Change the line, go again.
You're battering her, says Stuart Scott. It's fair analysis, the way the fight's gone up to now. And Chapman wants to get on with things, hence the ambition to fight Serrano. She's ranked 11 by the WBC at the moment, but there's a chance a Serrano fight might not be that far away, provided she comes through this one tonight unscathed. And so far, she's done everything right. And it's been a familiar pattern. Every round so far, Richie, has looked pretty much the same. Raven Chapman piling forward and forcing Linda Lecca back.
Boxing well, setting things up behind the jab. There it is there, just measuring the distance and gap with that punch, and then switching the attack downstairs, listening to the corner. So yes, at the moment she's boxing very well. The intensity, the work rate, Lecca can't cope with it.
Lecca just started looking a little bit more demoralised in there as well, as the punches continue to land, and there's no sign at the moment of Raven Chapman slowing down. Absolutely in tip-top condition, isn't she?
Yes, she is indeed. Like I said, that right hand over the top from her is a put there, it was there. That's the shot she's got to target. Got to try and there, it was there, not far away. So she's got to try and draw the lead of her opponent and then whip that shot over the top. Because look how low that lead hand is of Lecca.
Chapman tries to land the right hand. We're halfway through the fifth round here, and there's never really been a period in any of the rounds so far where you felt that Lecca's had any kind of foothold in the fight. It's been one-way traffic, total domination so far for Raven Chapman.
Lecca's experience, you can see that with her. The movement's good. She's tried to stand and trade. She's been on the receiving end in that department. She's getting outboxed. And she's struggling on the ropes also, so yeah, this is a tough night for her. And Raven Chapman just keeps coming forward,
piling on the pressure, landing with lefts and rights, and there's nothing at the moment Linda Lecca can do to keep her off, and she'll be mighty relieved to hear the bell. It's hard work in there, Richie, for Linda Lecca.
Yes, it is indeed. She's on the receiving end there. Last 20 or 30 seconds, Chapman really poured it on, and yes, I think she's starting to feel the pace.
And
Andrew Kane there, just getting in the gloves, getting gloved up. Very explosive, very exciting fighter, isn't he? And there's his opponent.
Talk about people wanting to make a statement tonight. Jonathan Volutte has never been stopped as a professional, and I know that that's a big ambition tonight for Andrew Kane.
Well, he says that he'll be the first one to stop him, so he's set out. It's going to be tough for him, but yes, he's certainly got the power to do that.
That's up next, Andrew Kane of Liverpool against the Romanian Jonathan Volutte. Sixth round scheduled for 10. WBC International Featherweight title. We don't have the judges' cards, but conventional wisdom ringside is that this has been a landslide so far for Raven Chapman. Lecca lost the last fight, which was an IBO Super Flyweight title challenge. In fact, she's lost three of her last five, which might just indicate the best days are behind her, but that shouldn't diminish in what we're seeing tonight from Raven Chapman, who's been outstanding throughout the fight so far.
A good all-round display from Chapman. He set up these attacks very well behind that jab. Managed to pin her opponent onto those ropes, and then she switches the attack like she does there, right on cue. Works the body.
All of the time because of the pressure she's under from Raven Chapman. That's good work again. A lot of the punches were taken on the gloves and on the arms by Lecca, but all the same, there's so much gas in the Chapman tank, she just keeps throwing punch after punch.
My work rate, fast tempo from Chapman. Such a bad shot there from Lecca in right hand.
To the body again, and there's the bell. Well, that's been impressive throughout the fight, Richie. The attacks to the body from Raven Chapman, she's been very accurate. They must be starting to take a toll.
Yeah, 100%, and also when she switches the attack, she starts at the head and then goes downstairs. That's been very impressive indeed. I thought that last round probably she took the foot off the gas a little bit. Did Raven Chapman, the intensity wasn't quite as much as the previous few rounds,
so,
but nevertheless, she still won the round.
And then grip your feet a little bit, hold the ground, all right? So, have a little go. Throw your shoulder right hand low, throw it high, give me that little kick step and look for those double left hands, all right? See if we can get through something like that. Got enough energy to give me that? Sure? What? Yeah? All right, so, show her down, crack her eye, and then when you get the opportunity, get round her. Try and get that angle to the right so you get that right arm working, yeah? Right?
Go. Well, they come then for the seventh, still to come tonight. Andrew Kane against Jonathan Volutte, that comes next. We've got the second professional fight for Moses Itauma, Jason Cunningham against Miguel Gonzalez, and then Nathan Heaney against Jack Flatley. Cuffing right hand landed by Raven Chapman, who's been the dominant fighter in there right from the opening bell.
Just going to watch out for that right hand over the top from Lecca. She tried to throw it earlier on and just missed by a mile, but nevertheless, she's thinking about that shot also. There it is there, look, and just clips Chapman. Occasionally you see that Lecca just holds her feet and just fancies her chances, but it's just the sheer work rate from Chapman is just overpowering opponent.
She's been an irresistible force in there up to now. I think it's a night where Lecca's needed all of the experience that she's picked up in 23 fights and numerous title fights. It's probably what's got her this far in the contest. The pressure continues to come, it's relentless pressure from Raven Chapman.
She probably expected Chapman to slow down a little bit, certainly by this point, but Chapman, very fit, keeps coming. High work rate from Chapman. I think Lecca probably thought after two or three rounds she'll slow down a little bit, but now we're into round seven and Chapman is still coming on strong, looking for the big shots downstairs again. Dangerous place to be on those ropes, Fletch. When your feet come square like that, that's when you can get caught with big body shots. That's when you've got to move. She instinctively moved off there and again just gets away with it. Good round for Chapman again.
Right, sit right back.
All right, nicely breathing. Over the nose, over the mouth.
This fight
is essentially one, right? So let's try and have a little bit of fun, right?
Okay, let's try and show the crowd a little bit of saying what you can do.
Take the first minute of this round, right? Get in behind your jab nicely, just control, like you've been doing it with his head movement, but save a little bit of energy for when she's a little bit more tight. See if you can get around her a couple of times for me, alright? There's every chance you're hurting her a lot to the body. Every single thing you've
done. So another good round, there's that right hand there. That was thrown at the start of the round, but she's thinking about that punch, Lecca. She actually threw another one in the round that actually caught Chapman. There it was there, a little bit of a coffin punch, but nevertheless, that's on her mind.
Richie, it's an extremely confident corner. Well, the chief second says, let's have a bit of fun in this round. They're just fighting out the jam for a minute, then after that, we'll see if we can get around her a little bit more. They're so confident in the Raven Chapman corner. It's not very often you hear those kind of instructions.
Confidence indeed from the coach and the boxer. But it's been a great performance up to now, hasn't it, from Chapman? An all-round boxing performance and the fitness has been there. So yes, the coach now just wants her to have a little bit of fun, work more with that left hand.
It's also Raven Chapman's first 10-round fight tonight, so going deep into the contest against someone as experienced as Linda Lecca will be a tremendous learning situation for her, especially the way that she's gone about the work in there. I suppose all it's lacking at the moment is the big punch to really turn it. There's still time to do that. Eighth round scheduled for 10. It's going to take something extra special from this point for Linda Lecca to do anything about the result.
This is a good learning fight for Raven Chapman. She's in against someone who's been a good mover, who's extremely tough, took some real good shots, and you know, and who's still competitive to a certain degree. So this has been a great step up for her, a first 10 rounder as well.
Really good work to the body again from Raven Chapman. You have to give Linda Lecca credit for being able to get through what she's got through tonight. She's needed all of the guile and experience, subtle movements in there to avoid some of the punches that have been coming her way. She's done that really well.
Yeah, she's experienced, isn't she? She's been 10 rounds, 9 times, remember. Former world champion as well at a lower weight, so yes, experience. And you can see she knows what she's doing in there.
Final stages of the eighth round, another dominant round for Raven Chapman. Just falling a little bit short with the right hand, and then the old Sugar Ray Leonard showboat at the end. I saw him do that against Marvin Hagler all those years ago, Richie. Yeah. Sticks the chin out, the tongue didn't come out, but it was the next best thing.
It's been a good fight, hasn't it?
Big night for him, isn't it? Jason Cunningham. The last time we saw him, he was on the end of a beating at the hands of Zolani Tete. And there's still repercussions about that night, but he's smiling in there, he's having the bandages put on, and he knows he's got to come out tonight, Richie, and get back to winning ways.
Yeah, good kid Cunningham, isn't he? Tall, southpaw, and does the weight very well. He's tall for super bantam, and it wasn't his night against Tete, but nevertheless, he's still a quality performer.
He's up against a man from Chile tonight, Santiago Miguel González, who's won 33 of his 36 fights, so an interesting one coming up later on tonight for Jason Cunningham. So this is the first time in Raven Chapman's short professional career she's gone into the ninth round, so a fresh experience from this point on for Raven Chapman.
And still keeping the work rate going. And yes, it is new territory for her, flex, but she looks in good nick, good condition, and again putting the punches together.
I presume this is the kind of night that when you're part of the Raven Chapman team, it's, oh, that's a really good left into the body. A wild swing from Lecca, and she was really punished by the body shot, and they really are thudding into the ribcage of the lady from Peru.
Yeah, she's tough, isn't she, Lecca? No doubt. Chapman is landing with some good body shots, and again there, we've seen her just sink that left up into the body.
I'm just going to make the point that if you could script the night, it would probably be this. Plenty of rounds in the bank against an experienced fighter, which kind of adds to your own experience. And of course, she's boxed so well that she's been the dominant fighter throughout. So it's probably ticked every box, the fight so far, for Raven Chapman.
It's a great blue flex because it's the caliber of boxer you're up against, a former world champion who knows what she's doing. And it's been total dominance, hasn't it, for Raven Chapman, for me.
Be surprised if she's lost a round up to this point.
Chapman just sensing now, Flex, that she's getting the better of her opponents here, and she's landed a couple of good shots there.
She continues to come forward.
Out, get your arms up, nice deep breathing in through the nose, out of the mouth. One more push. Right, have a little gob. Spit that one. Lovely. Right, how much energy you got there? How much energy you got there? Right, nothing careless, nothing stupid, alright? But get out there and stick it on, alright? You know you can now, there ain't nothing coming back. Just be prepared to keep bobbing, weaving round, look for the counters, alright? But as soon as you back her up to those ropes, have a spell. Just have a nice little big, big round to send this paradigm at me. It's been punch perfect, Chapman's. Punch perfect. You ain't lost a round. You ain't lost a second of a round. Alright? One last big effort, alright? Enjoy this one. Maintain your shape. Keep pressing that back with that jab. When you get there, let the hands go, alright? It's been a great performance.
Richie, I'd agree with everything Stuart Scott just said. I don't think she's lost a second of a round, has she? She's been that good. Whether she can find the stoppage in the 10th and final round remains to be seen, but I think she's certainly going to come out and try and land the shot to get her the stoppage.
I think she'll go for the stoppage if she can. She's going to really pour on the pressure. Here she is now. But yes, it has been a good performance, and the corner just wanted to finish the show in style here. That's a good right hand down the middle there from Chapman.
Well, you would say that there are always questions when you haven't seen a fighter go 10 rounds. That was Raven Chapman's case. The way she's finishing this fight would indicate she could pretty much start again and still have the energy, and there is the first knockdown. And it was the sheer volume and the pressure that was applied to Linda Lecca, and in the end there was no alternative but to go down onto the canvas. Now we'll see if Chapman can get the stoppage. How much is left in Lecca's tank? Great shot to the body, good one into the head with the right hand. Lecca hanging on, Raven Chapman now desperate to get the finish.
There's the sign there, that was a good shot, it was a good body shot went in there. Lecca's holding on, she was in trouble a little bit there. This would be the icing on the cake if she could get the stoppage. Just a minute to go, and she's pouring on the pressure. Raven Chapman going for the stoppage.
And John Latham, the referee, isn't too far away. Tremendous bravery here from Lecca to bite down on the gun shield and stay in there. Ferocious pressure coming her way from Raven Chapman. 40 seconds of the 10th and final round to go. Can she find the finishing punch? She's been outstanding tonight, dominated this fight. All she wants now to complete the night, make it perfect, is the stoppage. And there's not much left for Lecca. John Latham's waiting. Is he going to step in and stop it? Lecca somehow finds the reserves to keep going in there.
Just wants that one clean shot, doesn't it, for the referee just to jump in there.
I think he thought about it,
he
Richie.
He did, definitely. He was looking, wasn't he? It looks like Lecca's going to get through, but Raven Chapman again pouring on the pressure.
Well, there's the final bell, and that was a quite outstanding performance tonight from Raven Chapman. There's little doubt she's defended her WBC International Featherweight title. She was so close to becoming the second woman to stop the very experienced Linda Lecca. I think she did everything right in there, Richie.
That was a real good performance from Raven Chapman, right from the opening bell. Set out her stall, work well behind her jab, switching the attack, backing her opponents up on the ropes. Lecca, good tactics early on. She knew she had to hit and she had to move. This is the final round. Great right hand went in there. Lecca's in trouble. That actually started when she went down. Was that from that right hand? But Lecca, you've got to give her great credit. A tough, tough fighter indeed, who went right to the very end, avoiding shots. This is when the referee was taking a look. You just see they're just missing the target, but that's the experience of Lecca, just ducking and diving, just getting out of the way.
Got to remember as well tonight, Richie, that's just the sixth professional fight for Raven Chapman. She's in there with a woman who's been a world champion. She's had 12 title fights before tonight, and she's got all of the experience. And in reality, she never really had an answer at all to anything that Raven Chapman did.
I think she felt the power early on from Chapman, then, you know, got on her bike. She knew she was up against sort of a bigger opponent. So she moved Lecca those first couple of rounds. But then she held her feet and tried her luck, probably on the inside and trying to push Chapman back, which then she came off second best again. So Chapman showed that she beat her in every department. That is a really good display for a boxer who's only had six contests against a former world champion. That's a cracking display.
Raven Chapman smiling in the ring. It was a really good night for her. Let's get confirmation of what we expect to be a landslide victory from Thomas Triver.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds of boxing, we go to the judges' scorecards, and all three judges, Victor Laughlin, Francisco Ayosa Rosa, and Christoph Fernandez, are in agreement. They all score at the same 100-89. All in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And still, Women's WBC International Featherweight Champion, Raven, the Omen Chapman!
That's a fantastic performance tonight from Raven Chapman. She has the great Amanda Serrano in her sights. A shutout victory tonight.